Hey everybody, Gear here. Wanting to do a little bit of an amendment to my Terrain in You video, because it's come to my attention through some of the posts and also from one of my friends have said that there are some gaps in my explanation. Once again, this video is about stuff I kind of do intuitively. So as I was describing it, I think I was just skipping some things because to me it's like, oh, this is apparent and easy and I don't need to talk about it. And for some of you, or for maybe for a lot of you, maybe that made the video more confusing. So hopefully with this little amendment, I can help clear things up. So first off, terminology, battle line. I've used it in some of my videos before. It just refers to the front of your army. So however your army is arrayed, imagine a line going along it, and that's your battle line. With terrain, you're looking for terrain that's going to cause gaps or breaks in the battle line. So if it creates a gap in the line, that means part of the enemy army is essentially cut off. Which then, if anything's cut off, it's easier for you to attack it with a greater force and then kill it, because less of the enemy army can come back and prevent it, or prevent a credible counterattack. So that's what you're looking for. You're also looking for terrain that's going to cause a delay in the enemy movement. So if there's a woods in front of the enemy unit, it's going to take them a little bit longer, it's going to take them twice as long to get to the halfway point of the board. So you're wanting to look to exploit that. So if the terrain is across an objective, well, that means you can rush up past the objective and try to delay the enemy from getting it, because they are going to already be slowed down by the terrain, which lets you push forward more and protect the objective better. Let's see. And then finally, you know, with the terrain around the objective. You're doing what I previously said, which is looking for where it's going to delay the enemy and try to exploit that by then keeping them away. And then you're also just looking at the terrain that's around the objective to see, okay, where is the enemy going to get to? And how am I going to get him out of that terrain? And that's where you're going to take your units that can maybe charge through it, shoot through it, blast it with AoEs, whatever's in your army, how to deal with it. As far as mitigating terrain and how it affects you, it's as simply as taking those models that have Pathfinder or whatever to move through it so you don't create the gaps. You have fast units that can mitigate the terrain by just being so fast that they don't really create a big break in the line. Maybe you take some longer ranged weapons so that you're saying, all right, this part of the board I can't really get to because there's so much terrain, but I don't want the enemy to use it to try to flank me. So I'll put some guns in play so that if they try to go through this area, I'll just shoot them. So I hope that this video clears up the last one. Let me know if it doesn't. And hopefully in the future, I don't make so many mistakes in a video. I'm not sure if I'll be completely redoing this video in the future now. Maybe one day if I have the time and I can start redoing videos, this will probably be on the top of the list. But yeah, once again, I hope this is clear. Sorry for the confusion. And until next time, this is Gear Jock out.